Great news, as Mitch McConnell wishes everyone a beautiful weekend.
Well, actually, no, he didn't say that. You know. Does he wish you a nice week? A nice month? No, he doesn't wish you that either. Does he want you to offer you a lobster bill? No, he doesn't want to offer you that either. What does he think about the president? He's not going to say that publicly, what he really thinks about the president. How about the GOP senators who don't want to give you stimulus? Oh, he adores them. Nancy Pelosi, wishless. Democrat, wishless. Joe Biden, Democrat, wishless. Millions of Americans getting rich on the American dollar. It's everyone versus Mitch McConnell. It's Mitch McConnell versus the world. But the good news is that the world is going around Mitch McConnell and getting their stimulus. This is McConnell versus Trump. Hey, good afternoon, everybody. I'm here, you're here, and Mitch McConnell's probably having some lobster. Probably sipping that martini in the jacuzzi in the Tahitian resort that he's probably about to go as he celebrates his re-election. But what about us? What about our stimulus? And what about Donald? Is Mitch working against Donald? Is Mitch trying to steal your stimulus? Or what is really Mitch doing? This video is going to be unlike any other video seen on McConnell versus Trump because I have breaking news and shocking news across the board. Go fund his channel and subscribe. Because I'm doing something a little bit different today in which I'm cutting through a lot of the crap and I'm just giving you the real core of where everyone really is, because they are not going to tell you themselves. Also, like this video. In this video, I will be doing exactly that. I will be telling you where things are with Mitch, where are things with Mitch and Donald, where are things with Mitch and Steve, and where are things with Mitch and Nancy. That's basically all of that and more. And what does this have to do with your stimulus? And why was Mitch brought up in the last presidential debate last night? And yet, if you didn't catch it, you may not have realized anyone was referring to. All right, let's get to the breaking news. The breaking news is that Mitch McConnell, categorically, literally, in every sense of the world, really does not really care whether you get stimulus or not. And so as we sit here today, we can hear all these narratives from the president. You can have all these narratives, Mnuchin and Meadows. And ultimately, Mitch doesn't really care whether you have stimulus because he's getting reelected. Mitch McConnell is leading his Democratic opponent in the election campaign for Senate seat by about 6 to 8%. So he's a sure bet to be reelected for his 9,000th term. And being reelected, he will either see a Senate majority of Democrats or a minority of Democrats. He hopes it's a minority so that he's the majority leader. But ultimately, he wants to be either Senate majority leader or Senate minority leader. He wants to be the leader. And that would make him the number two Republican in the nation if the president's reelected, and the number one Republican in the nation if the president loses. And that's a term that the president, that Mitch McConnell likes, being number one or number two. And so as you sit here today, where is the situation with Mitch McConnell and your stimulus? Let's go over Mitch McConnell and the president. And before I get to Mitch McConnell and the president, let me go actually over to Mitch McConnell and Mnuchin. New data this afternoon reveals that the Republican leadership is irate with Steve Mnuchin, not just upset, irate. And ironically, this has been building for weeks, and I've been detailing for you weeks. This is really shocking news. The shocking news is that Steve Mnuchin, who is not a former senator, he is not a former House member, he's not a former congressman, he's a former Wall Street guy that was picked from Wall Street from a very luxurious condo that's currently for sale. If you have, I don't know how much he wants, I think he wants like $120 million, reduced from $320 million, or you know, it's Nancy Pelosi times 900. It's very expensive. He is a Wall Street exec who has been picked to be the Treasury Secretary, and he has never worked a day in his life in Congress, and so he doesn't know anyone in Congress. Okay, well, that would work if you interact with these people, you commiserate with these people, and you feel like you're part of the family, sort of like how we're part of a family. I may not know you, you may not know me, we may not braid each other's hair, you may not save any bacon for me on mornings at late, and I may be pissed every morning that you're not saving bacon for me, but we're ultimately a family. Steve Mnuchin's not putting that effort in, has never put that effort in, and the new news reports say it's hurting your stimulus. Why? Because Steve Mnuchin is having negotiations with Nancy Pelosi, not telling anyone. He's not telling anyone what's going on. The Republican leadership is now speaking out saying, hey, this has to stop. We're not knowing what's going on until we tune into LA Light. They're not saying me, but they're basically saying until they turn on the broadcast news. They have no idea what the deal offers are. They have no idea what the deal terms are. And they have no idea what's going on in the negotiations. And so they're not happy because ultimately it's their job. Let me explain something, if this is not clear. Mitch McConnell and the Senate and Nancy Pelosi and the House, their job is to pass laws, not Steve Mnuchin. Steve Mnuchin is not normally the person who would be doing this. Normally, the people who pass laws are lawmakers, legislators. As Nancy Pelosi says, we're legislators. As though that makes her sound any better than she is. We're legislators. Legislators pass laws. Legislators negotiate laws. Legislators go over the terms of the laws. Steve Mnuchin is not a legislator. And so the president thought it'd be cute to adopt Steve Mnuchin as his person who would negotiate on behalf of all of us, well, half of all of us, and that no legislators who are Republicans would be negotiating the bill. That ultimately has hurt the president. And as Mitch McConnell has seen, it's hurt Donald Trump and everyone around him. Mitch McConnell was excluded from the negotiations early on by Nancy Pelosi, and that was a tactical bad move by her because ultimately she is now isolating everyone, including the Republican leadership. So, Mitch McConnell versus Mnuchin, not going well. The tensions between Mitch McConnell and Steve Mnuchin date back to July, as I detailed on this channel exclusively at the time, that Mitch McConnell was supposed to work with Steve Mnuchin in drafting the HEALS Act. That ultimately, what happened was they had a fight. They confirmed the fight to broadcast news, and Mitch said, you know what, I'm going to write the bill. You go do what you got to do. And that's what they went and did. They separated ways. Mitch wrote the HEALS Act. He introduced the HEALS Act. It died, and the president insulted Mitch McConnell about the HEALS Act publicly in his cabinet, enough that press heard about it, and Mitch McConnell didn't like it. Do you think you would like it? I wouldn't like it. So suddenly, the tensions were clear. The tensions are more clear today as Mitch McConnell and the Republican leadership are speaking out saying, we have no idea what the secretary is doing. We have no idea what Secretary Mnuchin is doing. He doesn't tell us what he's doing. And he thinks he's above us. He thinks he's isolated from us. He needs to brief us on what's going on. Interesting. There was a point at which Mitch McConnell was being briefed back in July, but that is no longer the case. Then Mitch versus Pelosi. These people's feuds date far before this channel. Their feuds date to the 1800s. They've been in Congress since the 1800s. At that time, Mitch McConnell had a personality, and his face, you know, looked a little bit different. But these people have been in Congress since the 1800s, and their feuds are very deep and thin. So Mitch McConnell loves to do anything that just makes Nancy Pelosi just not be happy. And ultimately, if it results with you not getting stimulus, hey, that's even better. So as we sit here today, Mitch McConnell versus Pelosi is an obvious situation. But what about Mitch McConnell versus Donald Trump, the title of this video? Where is Mitch McConnell with Donald Trump? It has not been a new story this week that Mitch McConnell focuses on Mitch McConnell and doesn't focus on Donald Trump, and that ultimately Mitch does what Mitch needs, not what Donald needs. That story was detailed on this channel back in July. At the time, Mitch told insiders and told other Republicans in the Senate that, you know what, I think you need to defend for yourself and fend for yourself because I don't think the president's doing it. So ultimately, if you need to pass legislation or not pass legislation, don't look to the president. Let's do it ourselves. And that did not go well. The president heard it. I heard it. You heard it. So certainly the president heard it. That's reascending today and this week. The president is now hearing that Mitch McConnell is telling Republicans, don't align with the president because he may not get reelected. Focus on getting yourself reelected. And if that means breaking rank with the president on policy, breaking rank with the president on any issues like stimulus, go do it. President doesn't like that. So as you sit here today, it really is Mitch and Mitch's buddies against everyone. So what does that mean for your stimulus? What does it mean for stimulus by executive order? What does it mean for stimulus by legislative order, legislative action? I don't see legislatively any path for stimulus as I sit here on a Friday afternoon before this election, because I just think that the president's not going to put it up for a vote. Mitch is not going to put it up for a vote. Nancy's not going to put it up for a vote. Mnuchin's not going to put it up for a vote. And there's actually no bill to put up for a vote because they haven't written one. So I think it's a little bit obvious what's going on at the moment. What's important to understand is that there's a lot of reasons why executive orders are needed. And those obvious reasons is that Mitch McConnell's not going to give you a law. So why are we focusing on Nancy? Why are we focusing on Steve? Why are we focusing on Mitch? These people don't want to give you stimulus. They don't want to give you enough stimulus, or they don't want to give you the stimulus that you need. Ultimately, there's two things to remind yourself about, or actually three. The first one is that executive orders is one push, and that pushing for seats for stimulus is another push, and that the fact that you're pushing for one does not negate the other. Let me explain that. Basically, if Steve Mnuchin and Nancy Pelosi actually come up with a bill and a law tomorrow and says, hey, it's now law, that does not negate your ability to get executive orders. You need to push for executive orders, because ultimately, executive orders are the fastest way to get stimulus. What I've said, not very clearly as I would have liked in recent videos, is that the president can do these executive orders for you for stimulus checks of the $800 billion that's unused for PPP money. And you could turn around and in November, Steve and Nancy and Mitch could actually get this to the finish line and get you a bill and get you a law for a stimulus check after that. One does not negate the other. So what's important to understand is that the fact that we're pushing for one thing does not mean we're pushing against something. And the other thing that you need to understand is that whatever Mitch is doing for purposes of pushing back with Pelosi, in a strange way, somehow helps you. Because Nancy Pelosi's bill is not right. It's not correct. We all know that. I mean, we haven't seen the final version because it's not agreed upon. We haven't seen where Steve and Nancy are on certain issues. And if you watch the video earlier before this one and the one before that, I said, hey, there's no agreement on FPUC. So guess what? There's no agreement on FPUC. And hence, Purple Power is going to say what they want for FPUC. There's no agreement on stimulus checks, apparently. So Purple Power is going to say what they want for stimulus checks. So if this eventually lands in the Senate, or lands in the House and the Senate, guess what? As Mitch does his little thing that, you know, I want to get out a scissor and start cutting. This is Mitch. Cut, 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 cut. Guess what we're going to do? We're going to start getting a shovel, start putting more back into the bill. You took out the hazard pay. We're going to put the hazard pay back in the bill. You tried to reduce the stimulus check. We're going to put the stimulus check bigger in the bill. And you tried to take out our FPUC and not go retroactively enough. We're going to get a push brush and push you back to July so that you get your, with our push brush, we're going to push you back to July so you pay FPUC to late July. The strange dichotomy of the situation is that, yes, we're pushing for executive orders. Yes, we're trying to get those executive order stimulus. But in the same regard, the fact that GOP senators are not liking the situation, this is the fact that Mitch is not liking the situation, the fact that a lot of people are not liking the situation, guess what? We don't like the situation either. And we're going to start demanding a lot more money. And we've actually already started demanding more money. So when we talk about McConnell versus Trump, ultimately, it's starting to become, in a way, McConnell and Purple Power versus Pelosi, because, you know, if Pelosi doesn't want to give you this type of stimulus you're owed, then we're going to push back just like Mitch is pushing back against Pelosi. You're owed $2,000 a month. It has been 6 months. You were on pandemic lockdown for 3 months. You got paid one check, or if you're an adult dependent, you didn't get a single check. The numbers for COVID-19 cases are very serious and very real. They're escalating in rapid numbers. In LA County, well, not LA County, Southern California counties are now going backing up on the color pattern, or whatever you call that thing. So gyms that were open are closing again. Hair salons that are open are being closed again. Sorry, Nancy. And that what's going on is that we're getting closer and closer to lockdowns. And as you get closer and closer to lockdowns, what's Nancy Pelosi's position? I have one stimulus check for you to cover you for the next 12 months. No. This is Purple Power. Who do you think you're dealing with, honey? I say that with a laugh, but I'm serious. I mean, this is Purple Power. Who do you think you are, Nancy Pelosi, giving $1,200 stimulus check to people who have been on lockdown since the spring? That ain't going to work, honey. Ain't going to work in a Democratic society. Ain't going to work in a Republican society. No person is going to say, I accept $1,200 to cover me through two lockdowns, the thick of winter of fall 2020, and to carry that all the way to spring of 2021 when Joe Biden comes in under your scenario. Mm-mm. So Purple Power, here we go. Purple Power, we understand that Mitch is a resistance, but we're a resistance. We're a resistance, and we understand that it's McConnell versus Trump, but it's also Purple Power pushing Trump. It's also Mitch McConnell pushing Pelosi, and it's Purple Power pushing Pelosi and pushing Mnuchin, saying, hey, these numbers that Joe Biden talked about last night, well, he actually didn't talk about numbers, he talked about stimulus, we're talking about staying local. Okay, we've had enough chatter about staying local. It has lasted a lifetime, it feels like, to hear about staying local from these elected officials. It's time to start sending out stimulus checks. And it's time to get some of the incredible comments from yesterday. And they were very good. Groku. So we just act like we don't see these politicians literally playing with our lives. This is really like a game to them. Some evil people we must pray people for. Carol Rulalas, this is a roller coaster ride. October's coming to an end and November's rent is due. They're failing us like no one else. I'm trying to stay optimistic. Carla Lee, Mitch worried about Mitch. Broad's big adventures. Mitch McConnell already hurt the Republicans' bid for re-election when he decided to pause for summer. Now the clown's really going to kill this party. Susan Dossett, Congress is in a sorry state of affairs. Kelly Hawks, Mitch was never on board for stimulus. Jan J, stimulus from coworkers to families. If all and anyone is talking about it's what everyone is talking about every day. So much so, I have a nightmare about it last night. Looking forward to the debates tonight. Will Trump discuss Joe's tax increases? I don't think he did. I did. Denny Johnson, I know the president's debate is tonight, but my favorite series is Supernatural on CW. I'm going to watch the show. I'll get all my info I need for the debate here on LA tonight afterwards. Purple Power, well, thank you. And I did have a lot of details on it. The Nature of Wild Martins. Mitch needs to go. The Temple of Doom needs to follow and take a ride. Christine Aguilon, Mitch McConnell, get out of the house and take Nancy Pelosi with you. Go to front of the channel, subscribe, because no one's getting you through this in a day in which there's a lot of twists and turns, and we're not even to the weekend yet. We got a few more hours for them to do crazy things. You think they will? Also, like this video. Coming up next is Pelosi versus Mnuchin, a video you cannot miss because there's going to be a lot of shockers and a lot of twists and turns. As always, stay informed, stay smiling, and stay up LA for more.